Hello, in this tutorial series, I'm going to cover just about comments and how to insert them and manage them and assign them to students. So the first thing that we're going to do here is just click on a slide, and I'll go back to the number one slide. And if I hit comment, it's going to put a comment for the entire slide. So for this comment purpose, it's just information on the entire slide. And then I hit comment and hit enter. So now I've inserted the comment for the entire slide, and you can see it outlines in yellow the slide. Now, if I want to give specific advice to something like either a text box, a picture, an object, all I have to do is click on the text box or object or picture and go up to the comment tool and select it. And notice that the comment now highlights that text box field in yellow and addresses it. Now, to give this to a student, all you have to do is hit plus and type in a student's name and then click it. And now you can again hit enter and you can type feedback or more information on what you want them to do. And then you can even assign it to the person and hit assign. What that means is it's going to send an email, they're going to be notified, they're going to click on it, it's going to take them right to that slide where you put that comment and give them information on what they need to do. So why is this beneficial? This is helpful if you've got a couple of students working on a collaborative project and you want to give feedback to specific students for tasks that they're responsible for. If it's a group project, the people in the group can give advice to each other and assign tasks to each other and keep each other working on the project. Same thing with two or more teachers creating a presentation. They can kind of coordinate with one another this way and give more descriptive or narrow down their feedback. So that's one way to insert the comment and address it to somebody. All right, so then again, if you want to edit your comment or reply, all you have to do is click on it and the other person could reply. I don't need to reply because that would be replying to myself. If I hit resolve, that basically means that, all right, I fixed it and the comment goes away. Again, you can always go to comments and see your history. And if something needs to be reopened, you can go up to it and click reopen. You can type something else if you want and bring attention to it. But in this case, I'm not. And it's just going to bring up the whole comment history that was done for that one comment. So that's one way to bring back your comment history. Again, you can go to the three bars and edit it, delete it, get a link to this comment, and share that link to somebody who has access to this document. So all you have to do is copy this link and email it to somebody who has been shared access to this slide. Currently, no one has access to this slide because you can see it says private to only me. And if I want to share it, all I have to do is click on that and do that. So thank you so much for watching this short tutorial on the toolbar.